to start off the session with a quick recap so that, you know, we can continue from where we stopped last time. So just the first 5 to 10 minutes will just be a quick recap for what exactly we did last time so that no one is, left hanging. So to start off, we were talking about marketing workflows, and the idea about the entire session last time was we wanted to understand how we can work better, how we can get more things done, and what all is part of a marketing cycle and why we need a workflow. Okay. So one of the first things which we defined is what exactly is a workflow, which is nothing else but sequence of steps involved in moving from the start to an end of a working process. So when we talk about sequence of steps, beginning to an end, working process, this basically is nothing else but, in simple one word, a recipe or a formula. We also took a look at some of the popular workflows which we use in our day-to-day lives. So we saw an example of, you know, a latest food trend which is happening, like this wrap. We saw everyone's favorite Maggi. Maggi banane ka pura jo process hai, ek workflow hai. And peeche 4 step ya 5 step mein diya hua hai. Piche means on the backside of the wrapper. So this basically is the secret for any workflow. A workflow has to be simple sequence of steps which anyone should be able to execute. Look at education system, exercise, so on and so forth. We also took a look at what are the elements of a marketing workflow and why exactly we need this. Like, in marketing, we have a website, let's say maybe a social media page. We might be doing paid ads. We might be doing some events. And to actually juice up all of these things, we need content. So content actually is interesting because content har jagah pe chale jata hai. Like, content aapko website pe ke liye bhi chahiye rahega. Content aapko social media ke liye chahiye, ads ke liye chahiye, events ke liye chahiye. So content is one common factor across the table, and that's why today's session, what we are going to see or deep dive into, is mainly content workflows, okay, which are slightly different, which have a slightly different edge to it based on what we were trying to get out of it. We also took a look at, you know, who are the team members who you normally day to day work with. If you're a company, you might have these people on your team. If you are maybe an agency, or you're a company who is working with an agency, you might have a website agency rahega. Aapke paas social media ke liye alag agency rahega. People have different freelancers for blogs. People have a very different production company for videos. So the idea is there is a whole lot of teamwork required. There's a whole lot of coordination required across the table. Now, it's not important for you guys to know all of these things by yourself. This is where intelligence comes in. This is where things can work faster. What you need to understand is what are the elements of the other teams in terms of how they are working. Because if you want to drive any other team, if you want to collaborate with someone, if you want to work with a production team to create an ad for yourself or your company, you need to know ki wo log kya karne wale hain aur kis tarike se output tak pahunchenge. Because let me tell you one thing, if you have seen over the years, right, cameras and video technology has become cheaper as well as easily accessible. Internet speeds have gone up. So is wajah se kya hua hai, there are a lot of players in the market. There are a lot of people who will say, I will make a video for you. There are a lot of people who might say, I will make a website for you. But are they the right people? And you can easily find out when you talk to them, they will not have a clear answer to how they work. They will not have a clear answer to how they will get you the result which you are wanting or which they are promising you. Now, when you get these kind of answers, like which are vague, which cannot go from point A to point B, you can be sure this is not the right team to work with at that moment. I'm not saying ki they don't have the right intention. Intention hai, but unke paas experience nahi hai ki wo aapko result la ke de paaye. Okay, because there are few questions which people ask, and you know, we have to answer in a specific way. If we don't answer in a specific way, it kind of goes off, and it kind of is a clue that these people do not know what they are talking about. And that's where understanding workflows becomes crucial for anyone and everyone, irrespective of whether you yourself are, you know, the artist, or you are working with someone in collaboration to get you the result. So therefore, we need workflows. We created 3 workflows last time. Okay, we saw this simple formula, which was for marketing workflow. Strategize karna hai. Pehle, obviously, koi bhi cheez shuru karne se pehle, why do we need that particular piece of work, or why do we need that particular piece of marketing? वो स्ट्रैटेजी एक बनाना पड़ेगा. वी माइट हैव टू यू नो स्टार्ट बेस्ड ऑन द स्ट्रैटेजी. क्रिएटिंग का एक फेज होगा वेर इन द क्रिएटिव टीम कम्स इन टू प्ले. सो वी सो ईमेल मार्केटिंग एंड वी सेड ईमेल मार्केटिंग का स्ट्रैटेजी बनेगा. बट ईमेल मार्केटिंग का स्ट्रैटेजी बनने के बाद मेन है कि मुद्दा क्या है, वॉट आर यू गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट, वॉट इज द टॉपिक, हु इज योर कस्टमर, एंड दैट्स वेयर यू हैव टू गेट इन टू द क्रिएटिव प्रोसेस. So you need someone to write your email copy, and you need someone to actually make your beautiful HTML emailer. Then you need to review it. You need to review it whether the right message is going out based on, you know, to the target audience, whether the right message or offer is mentioned. Maybe a date is missing. I don't know. So there can be many parts to the cycle. You also have to send the email through HTML, so you need to check it on maybe your laptop, your mobile. Is the message, is the email getting communicated properly? Is it working? Are the links working inside? And that's where you review all that. Once your review process is done, if there are any changes, you might ask them, ki ye change karo, ye update karo. The link is not working, X, Y, and Z. And then finally, you can go to distribute, that is, shoot it out to a database. Then we discuss ki 2 se 3 din at least usko gestation time dete hain, so that because not everyone is going to wait for your email and they are like, oh, Jeet is sending me a mail, let me just look at it the moment it hits my inbox. That's not going to happen. So it will happen across 2 to 3 days when the person might check in a natural flow of checking their inbox. When they check the email, they might open it, or they might not open it, or they might actually click through the link which is given. So this gives us a lot of data to analyze. We analyze all of these things, and then we start repeating this entire process. Ki analysis ke baad we build an optimization plan, we build an insight report, and we say ki this marketing activity is generating XYZ results, so it's beneficial for us to repeat. Okay, so this is the whole formula which we gave. When it comes to content, the very basic formula which is there, if you see out here, yahan pe strategize, create, review, ye abhi we are looking at only the create ka part, okay, for content, and uska workflow dekh rahe hain. So create ke andar aapke paas pehle to jo strategy bana hai uska ek strategy ke baad ek brief banna chahiye, which is a creative brief. So any piece of content which you intend to make, maybe you intend to make a social media post, or maybe you intend to make a blog post or a video, it requires a creative brief. Okay, we'll go through what exactly is a creative brief in some time, but ek brief chahiye. This brief is something which is distributed amongst, you can say, the creators. It might also be distributed amongst, you can say, secondary creators, which I'll come to. Now, what happens in this creative brief is all the things are mentioned so that the person understands what exactly they have to create. They might have a process which is known as a pre-production process, wherein they do their research in terms of a blog, what is happening in the market, what are the things which are going on. For a video creator, they might do a pre-production like a storyboard. So they get the creative brief, they might build up their visuals around it, they might do some referencing, and they might share with you a very kacha pakka storyboard ki aisa kuch look and feel hai mere dimag mein, ये तरीके के एंगल्स में सोच रहा हूँ, एंड दैट इज द प्री प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस. आफ्टर दैट वंस द साइन ऑफ हैपेंस इन द प्री प्रोडक्शन, थिंग्स गेट इनटू प्रोडक्शन. प्रोडक्शन इज व्हेन लेट्स से इफ यू आर शूटिंग अ वीडियो द एक्चुअल शूट हैपेंस. ओके, प्री प्रोडक्शन में आप प्लान करते हो कि क्या कपड़े पहनने हैं, व्हाट इज द लोकेशन गोइंग टू बी, व्हाट आर द परमिशंस रिक्वायर्ड, ऑल दोस थिंग्स विल बी डन एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स विल बी यू कैन से गैदर्ड एंड परमिशंस आर यू नो टेकन. द प्रोडक्शन इज द डे ऑफ द शूट. ओके, वेर इन ऑल द क्रिएटर्स, ऑल द आर्टिस्ट आर इन वन प्लेस. If you're shooting a video, you might have the host, or you might have, let's say, the actors, you might have the sub actors, you might have the technicians like cameraman, lighting assistants, and so on and so forth. Okay, there is a lot of hoopla around this. So production day is busy. It might go from, if you're shooting a small video, it might be maybe a one day shoot. If you're shooting an extended video, it might be a 2, 3, 4 XYZ days ka shoot. Okay, like normally if you see Hindi movies are shot across a period of 30 to 40 days. Okay, that's a normal 3 hour ka movie banana hai to 30 se 40 din ka shoot hoga and various location mein hota hai. So similarly, production is all about getting the shot. Post production is about ki jitna bhi data production mein collect kiya hai usko edit karna hai, usko finally package karna hai, साउंड डालना है, म्यूजिक डालना है, एवरीथिंग, सो दैट वो एकदम चकाचक दिखे, सो दैट इट कैन बी रिलीज्ड. सो पोस्ट प्रोडक्शन इज वेयर ऑल द ग्लैमर हैपेंस. एंड फाइनली रिलीज आपने कर दिया, रिलीज किया तो उसका क्या परफॉर्मेंस हुआ, लाइक वेदर इट वॉज अ गुड वीडियो दैट गेन ट्रैक्शन, वेदर दैट डिडंट वर्क विद द ऑडियंस, एंड फाइनली देयर इज अ ऑप्टिमाइजेशन. नाउ दिस आई हैव ओवर सिंप्लीफाइड टू a crazy extent, and why I have done that is because everyone should understand this is the same process for any type of content, be it a blog. This is how you should do it. Okay, blog ke case mein we will see, we will create a very specific workflow, so I will get into the detail ki what all elements are there, but just giving you a basic idea. Okay, so let's move on. And let's actually create a workflow for a blog. So this was our last time ka sheet. Okay. What I'll do is, I'll use this guy. I'll just start typing here. Why I'm using the same sheet, or actually it's a different sheet. I've created a duplicate. Why I'm using the same structure is, the end of the day, we will get these three workflows out over here. And it'll be easier for me. All the fonts and everything has been, you know, set over here, so I don't need to think of anything else. So let's create a workflow for blog writing. Okay, as we saw, the parts over here which we have are brief, pre-production, production, post-production, and performance review. Let me just write this. So brief, pre-production, production, post, review, okay, right. Now so when we come to this part, we first of all want a brief. Now, what is a brief for a blog? Imagine the brief will be the most simplest part of it. You first need to start any blog brief with one person in mind, that is the SEO guy. Okay, you need a search engine optimizer to help you with the blog topic, to help you with the right keywords. So the first thing which you will require is a SEO plan. Okay, need to understand, whenever you write blogs, it is kind of a math. It is not going to be a artistic endeavor to start with. Isme art will come, the science has to come first. The science is all about Why we write blogs? We write blogs so that our website can rank higher on the food chain in terms of Google, so that when people are searching for certain things, we come out as a person or as a company that is the thought leader in that space. So the first thing which you will need is a SEO plan. An SEO plan has to be for a particular product or service, okay? And the idea should be to rank for certain keywords. Okay, so what keywords do I want to rank for? So this is like, you know, the first basic brief which you need to prepare with keywords. Why exactly, like which are the keywords that you want to rank for? You also need to understand who are your competitors in the space. Okay, so when you will give this information, this is the brief, right? This is the information which you'll be giving to the blog writer. The blog writer will appreciate your work and they will be like, hey, you have made my life simpler. I will perform for you even better. Okay, when you give more information, because normally what happens, again, a lot of blog writers are people who think they know how to write a blog. And they are people who know English. So many of them, this is a very oversimplification. Don't quote me on this, but I have seen, in my experience, I have seen people or I've met people who say they are blog writers, but they do not understand this science. So what I would do is I would specifically go with this data. Ki bhai, ye mere keywords hai. Mujhe iske around ek blog likhna hai. Ye mere competitors hai. Okay. Ye mera landscape hai. And what I'm expecting is, these are the things which I want to rank for, okay? Now, when I give them this data, okay, I will also give them few topics and I will also give them few USPs of the company, okay? Like what exactly, why do I as a company or why do I as a product, you know, want to stand out? So I will give them these things because this is the story. Okay, this will build the story. So I'll give them all this data. This makes my brief right. Okay, then I will ask them to start their work. So what they will actually start doing is they will start doing their pre-production process. Now pre-production, what they will do is based on the information which I have given on competitors, they should ideally start looking at competitor analysis, okay, and they should come up with a content gap. Now yahan pe I can actually give them a content gap. Now this is the number one thing which is missing from, or this is the science which actually a blog writer needs to follow, and this is something which is missing in today's you can say lot of SEO guys who are trying to work. They do not do this content gap analysis. Okay. What we are trying to do is imagine if I search for, so let's just search for a few things. If I'm searching for content marketing. Okay. Now, when I search for content marketing, what is happening is there are a few things which is coming up. So everyone over here has written about content marketing. Okay, I will make one step easier. I will go for content marketing Mumbai. Okay, when I am doing this again, you see naukri.com aa gaya hai, ye sari cheeze. So there is a lot of junk data which is coming in and I am not actually getting what I really want. Okay, that means if you see the first search, this is a agency listing site. Okay, over here, this is one site which is Penta Digital, which is a content marketing company, is what they are claiming. Then there is Naukri.com. So if you imagine right now, I am searching for content marketing Mumbai. The Google search is not understanding what exactly do I want out here. So there is a gap. If I do the same thing, if you see how I'm seeing this, if I do the same thing for digital marketing Mumbai, you can first of all see a lot of ads here. That means people are trying to कम ऑन टॉप फॉर डिजिटल मार्केटिंग एज अ कीवर्ड। कंटेंट मार्केटिंग के लिए कोई नहीं कुछ कर रहा है। पहला चीज जो यहाँ पे आपको दिख रहा है, जो गूगल भी दिखा रहा है, वो है डिजिटल मार्केटिंग एजेंसी सर्च हो रहा है। नाउ दिस इज ऑल द राइट थिंग्स विच यू नो गूगल इज थ्रोइंग अप एट मी। नाउ व्हाई गूगल इज एबल टू थ्रो दिस अप इन द राइट वे, बिकॉज पीपल आर वर्किंग टूवर्ड्स दिस कीवर्ड। व्हाट पीपल आर नॉट वर्किंग टूवर्ड्स इज कॉन्टेंट मार्केटिंग, बिकॉज कॉन्टेंट मार्केटिंग का सर्च इज नॉट ऑप्टिमाइज। ओके, इट्स जस्ट शोइंग मी रैंडम स्टफ। नाउ अ गुड एसईओ गाय विल टेल यू हाउ यू कैन एक्चुअली ऑप्टिमाइज दिस पर्टिकुलर कीवर्ड एंड कम ऑन टॉप ओवर देयर, एंड दिस इज वेयर द कॉन्टेंट गैप लाइज। ओके, सो द पर्सन विल टेल यू थिंग्स लाइक डिजिटल मार्केटिंग के केस में देर आर पीपल हु आर राइटिंग ब्लॉग्स और देर आर एजेंसीज। Now, what exactly are the keywords they are ranking for? What have they done on their website? So he will give you a complete analysis and gap, and then he will tell you, ye karo. Okay, so this is where content gap exists. And this particular understanding is something which the person should have if you are asking them to write a blog. If they don't, they might be good writers. So if they don't, it is your responsibility to give them that information. कि लिख तो सकते हैं वो, इज व्हाट वी हैव यू नो आइसोलेटेड। नाउ व्हाट अदर थिंग्स द पर्सन विल आल्सो डू इज दे विल फिगर आउट फ्यू टॉपिक्स एंड दे विल स्टार्ट आउट विद अ लूज स्ट्रक्चर। नाउ व्हाट दिस इज, दे विल बिल्ड अ प्लान। डोंट जस्ट गिव वन पर्सन वन टॉपिक टू राइट एवर। गिव अ ब्लॉग राइटर, वर्क विद देम ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम। So what you should, your pitch to a blog writer should be, ki, here is a topic, tell me what you can write, okay? Here are a few topics that I have on my mind. You do your research and then pitch to me few topics which you are really passionate about. The moment you give this freedom, the person will do a lot more, okay? So that's why you want them to create a pitch. Now, once the pitch is done, everything is done, then they come back and they start writing. Now, here for a blog, it is the most simplest thing, okay? First is they need to do a first draft, which should be a human draft. What is a human draft? It should be a draft ki, when they have actually searched online, they might be inspired. And when they got inspired, they start looking at it and they actually get into a flow wherein they start writing. And when they write like a human. So, which is the first draft, जहाँ पे free flow में लिखते जा रहे हैं. The second draft, okay, they need to now start thinking about the search engine, and they need to write like a bot. So, the second draft will be, जो भी human तरीके से लिखा है, how can I edit it so that it can actually, you know, work with the search engine. So, पहले draft में शायद से keywords उन्होंने लिखना उतना स्ट्रेस नहीं किया होगा, बट सेकेंड टाइम जब लिखेंगे, दे माइट थिंक ऑफ फ्रॉम अ कीवर्ड पर्सपेक्टिव। दे माइट थिंक कि ओके, गूगल इज रैंकिंग इट फॉर दिस फैक्टर, आई नीड टू राइट इट सो दैट द कीवर्ड इज प्रेजेंट, देर आर सम सिमिलर कीवर्ड्स विच आई राइट अबाउट, एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ। ओके, सो राइट लाइक अ बॉट इज द सेकेंड थिंग। देर आर फ्यू अदर थिंग्स विच दे कैन थिंक इन एनी आर्टिकल वॉट गूगल वॉन्ट्स। You know, there are these WH questions. Any article, now this is a very, you can say, so if I just search for content marketing, what Google throws up to us is, what is content in content marketing? What are examples? So, jitne bhi WH questions hai na, Google loves those. Okay? If you see what is ranking top, what is content marketing? What is content marketing? Forbes ne likha. Then when you go into this particular guide, which is the ultimate guide to content marketing in 2020, the moment you go inside, now the question which you will see is, what is content marketing? Okay, And they will specifically show it in a particular way because Google understands this. So what is content marketing? Why is content marketing? ये सारे questions जो है इनका जवाब देते जाएंगे. ओके, इफ यू सी डिजिटल मार्केटिंग जब सर्च किया था did I search for digital marketing Mumbai? Then let me just search for that again. So there is a digital marketer called Saurabh Jain. So Saurabh Jain ne, his article is actually ranking here in the first page of Google, which is top 20 marketing agencies in Mumbai. Now what he has done is he has answered the where. So where in Mumbai are good marketing agencies? So he is answering ki here are good agencies in Mumbai. So what happens at this point is you need to understand Google loves, as I said, WH questions. What are your WH questions? What is the definition? Okay, what basically implies definition of a particular thing, and Google ranks that on top. Okay, over here people also ask ye section kahan se aata hai, ye kisi ke article se hi aata hai. So if you click on this, and here you see this is coming from this particular site. They have actually written the topic, what are the 7 types of digital marketing. Okay, so if I search for, let's say I'll show you something interesting, content marketing Indian brands. If you see, Singularity ranks on top over here, 11 Indian brands that are rocking content marketing. So we understood one part ki Indian brands ke bare mein people want to look at. Okay, when we wrote this, so this single blog, when we wrote, okay, if we are thinking about what is the ROI of this, this single blog in a year got around, I think, 9,000 people to my website. Okay, so this is the power of, you can say, doing SEO research and building a blog. So you need to understand what people are searching for or what they are interested in. So this is where WH questions make a whole lot of sense. क्योंकि WH questions अगर आपके पास रहेंगे, Google को वो answer करने का कीड़ा है, because people what they do is they come on Google, they type a question. People use Google like you can say even with voice. So voice में digital agencies near me, content marketing agencies near me, ऐसे सब पूछते हैं. So when if your article gives that answer, Google क्या करता है? It runs the bots, so they pick that information. If there are 100 questions that have been asked, Google will actually tell you about these 100 questions. Okay, so this is where actually you need to start thinking like, what is Google ranking for? And WH questions are a crazy place to write your article. So when you are talking to your blog writer, if you tell them, bhai, ये चीज WH questions मुझे इसमें naturally डाल के दे, do not put it in a unnatural way. Okay, tell them to do the research, give them few reference websites, and they will find it. So WH questions they need to put. The final thing which comes is a grammar check, okay, which is obvious, and also there should be links, you know, link back to good websites. So none of the articles online which you see are without links. They should be linked back to good websites, and there should also be internal links. Internal links are basically links within your website. So let's say if you're talking about let's say for example we are talking about content marketing on our page. So content marketing ka कोई दूसरा आर्टिकल रहेगा विच एक्चुअली इज यूजफुल फॉर पीपल, आई विल गिव अ लिंक ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर आर्टिकल नेचुरली इन माय फ्लो. ओके, सो दैट इज समथिंग विच इज रिक्वायर्ड इन एनी गुड आर्टिकल. ओके, सो नाउ दिस इज ऑल इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इन टर्म्स ऑफ द प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस ऑफ अ ब्लॉग. सो दिस इज वेयर द ब्लॉग इज एक्चुअली रिटन. पोस्ट प्रोडक्शन में क्या आएगा? यू नीड इमेजेस इन योर ब्लॉग. सो जितने भी इमेजेस है वो आपको रेफरेंस के लिए आप वहां पे कोई टेम्पररी इमेजेस डाल के रखिए, बट पोस्ट प्रोडक्शन, लाइक पोस्ट प्रोडक्शन इमेजेस के लिए व्हाट यू विल नीड टू डू इज यू विल हैव टू एक्चुअली गेट इन टच विद द ग्राफिक डिजाइनर एंड गेट इट डन. व्हाट यू विल नीड इज अ गुड गुड कवर इमेज, बिकॉज कवर इमेज विल बी शेयर्ड अक्रॉस सोशल मीडिया. इंटरनल इमेजेस कैन बी सिंपलर, इट कैन बी स्टॉक बेस्ड, बट कवर इमेज थोड़ा अगर आप मेहनत करके यू कैन बिल्ड अ स्टाइल ऑफ योर ओन ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, इट विल रियली लुक गुड. टेक अ लुक, लेट्स टेक अ लुक एट फ्यू इमेजेस. वन सेकेंड. So there's a site called CoSchedule. I really like their blogs. It's actually a CRM and marketing automation company, but look at the artwork of their blogs. It's got a certain flavor to it. So it builds unka brand in this particular cover image. So whenever you are surfing online and you will see these colors, you will think about these guys. So that's what you want to do with your cover images. So images inside the blog can be simple. Okay, images inside the blog can also be something like you can say screenshots or something. So check this out. Look at the images which are here. Here there are simpler images like graphs and everything. Interface ke screenshots hai. And it's done. But outside, they have actually put in the effort and they have actually made this, in a particular style. So this is what we would want in any case. So that's your post. You also want someone to think of, like again, this is the content writer itself, but you want them to give a short description. Okay. You want them to give a social मीडिया यू कैन से कैप्शन. ये सारी चीजें एक साथ ही ले लो, आपका पूरा काम हो जाएगा. सो सोशल मीडिया कैप्शन आप सोच सकते हो, शॉर्ट डिस्क्रिप्शन सोच सकते हो, मेटा टैग सोच सकते हो. सो दीज आर थिंग्स व्हेन यू विल गिव दिस टू योर पब्लिशर, लाइक हूएवर इज पब्लिशिंग योर ब्लॉग, दैट पर्सन विल अप्रिशिएट इट बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव टू रन फॉर दीज थिंग्स एंड यू विल एंड अप सेविंग अ होल लॉट ऑफ टाइम व्हेन यू डू इट this way. So once it is all set, the blog is ready to be published. Performance review ke case mein, you will obviously, once it's published, at the end of 2 weeks or something, or maybe a month, start looking at this blog ka performance. You need traffic data for sure. You need something known as dwell time. Okay. Dwell time is nothing else but how much time has a person actually spent on this particular page. So you need, if you have written a big article, and I would say if you were to ask, like one of the main things which people normally ask is 250 words ka main blog likhunga, or what is the ideal word size or length of a blog. I would say start getting into the habits of writing long blogs. At least 1,000-1,500 words minimum hona chahiye. Okay, so when you write 1,000 to 1,500 words, what happens is the dwell time will automatically go up, because if you have written a good article, people will spend time on it. When people spend time on it, Google is analyzing this. Google analyzes this as a sign of authority, as a sign that you are doing good in terms of your content, and they will reward you by ranking you higher. So traffic data आपको चाहिए, how many people have come in, how many people have bounced off, all these things will be required. Dwell time is one important thing. The other thing which you need is where did people come from? Okay, traffic का source क्या था? So the intention for writing a blog should be it attracts more organic traffic. Right now, for us, as I said, that particular blog which I showed you, that got us 9,000 people in a year. Now, intention is, वैसे अगर if I write around 10 such blogs, I would be able to attract almost a lakh number of people to my site without any money. Like I have maybe spent once to create it, but I will get that uska benefit over a period of time. Then getting traffic gives me data. That data helps me create better articles, which then further helps me actually attract a lot more people onto my website and also drive them towards my other marketing funnels. कोई वेबसाइट पे आया है आप उनको बोल सकते हो मेरा ईमेल सब्सक्राइब करो. कोई वेबसाइट पे आया है आप उनको बता सकते हो ये वेबिनार है वेबिनार के लिए आ जाओ. सो दीज आर फ्यू थिंग्स विच वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट द होल परफॉर्मेंस रिव्यू इज डन. सो विद दिस द एंटायर ब्लॉग राइटिंग ब्रीफ वी हैव गॉट वी हैव अंडरस्टूड टिल अ सर्टेन पॉइंट. अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस इज अ वर्क फ्लो. ओके this needs to be used in tandem with professionals. You need good people to work for you, work with you, and then you will get the results out of this. Any questions till now? If there are any questions, feel free to use the chat or the Q&A console and I'll make sure to answer them. With this, let's move on to the next part, which is blog writing was one. Okay, the next thing which people are very much interested about in today's world is video. Like with the lockdown and everything, right, the whole impetus which is increased to another level in terms of people not using their TVs but using their mobile phones as the main screen to get information. News आपको भले ही टीवी पे दिख रहा था बट लोग कोरोना के बारे में कोविड के बारे में या जो भी चीजें या बिंज वॉच जो कर रहे हैं दे लाइक इट दे लाइक टू डू बिंज वॉचिंग ऑन देयर मोबाइल स्क्रीन्स और देयर लैपटॉप्स बिकॉज ऑफ प्राइवेसी. ओके इफ आई एम वॉचिंग नेटफ्लिक्स इफ आई एम वॉचिंग यूट्यूब इट इज कन्वीनियंट फॉर मी टू एक्चुअली व्यू इट ऑन माई मोबाइल. ओके there are few people who might think ki are yaar screen chota hai or something but wo screen chote bade ki baat nahi hai wo privacy ki baat hai. So that means video consumption has gone up, especially internet data rates have gone crazily down. Everyone today has data. Like if you step out and if you even talk to your watchman or something, they were on TikTok, now they are on TikTok. Okay, Takatak is a video social media network, which is a short form video network like TikTok. So people have gone crazy. You know, they have identified from TikTok. Like TikTok did one thing which is very good. TikTok ne boundaries hata di. Pehle kaise tha ki social media like Facebook, it was a very big step for your sabzi wala to be on Facebook. But TikTok has removed that and it has democratized the entire social media ka space. And actually all these people, like even villagers, you know, in places where maybe they were not on Facebook, they are to be found on TikTok. And people started communicating. Now, this is crazy and this has increased video consumption to another level. Now, when we say video consumption to another level, so the main thing is there is a lot of junk content which is being created and that's why videos need to be created right. Now, how do you create the right video? You can create the right video only by one thing, which is getting the right brief in place. Okay. Now, video ke liye, one of the first things you need to understand target audience kaun hai, for sure. You need to understand who exactly are you making this video for? What is your product or service? USP, okay? What are the benefits of your product or service? And when you search for video formats, okay, there are maybe I can write somewhere around 10 to 15 video formats, but still there will be more. What I mean by video formats are, video aap kis cheez ke liye use karne wale ho in your marketing cycle. Okay, there can be a video which is purely for sales. Okay, and that will be your ad. Your ad is nothing else but it is purely for sales. Okay. But there can also be video which can be towards teaching what your product is, teaching people how to use your product. Okay. And these are explainer videos. Okay. There can also be tutorials. If your product is complicated, it's a technology based product, let's say. You might have a, like right now, SaaS, which is nothing else but software as a service. Okay. We are all using software as a service. Like, say, for example, MailChimp, aap agar use kar rahe ho, ya aap Google Ads use kar rahe ho, Google Analytics use kar rahe ho, ye koi bhi platform agar aapne use kiya, then this is actually, in a way, you're using software for doing something. So software is being used as a service. Slack is one example for communication. Microsoft Teams, Zoom, all of these things are software as a service. Now, how do you use Zoom? There are videos on that. Okay. So when you go online on YouTube and you say Zoom, you can say walkthrough. How to use Zoom. Learn Zoom in 20 minutes. How to run a Zoom webinar. You know, these kind of videos, these are the tutorial videos. They will be, this guy has written it nicely, quick setup and tutorial. Then you start looking at, chalo main Zoom kar raha hun, but mujhe live stream karna hai. So live stream karna hai, achha, live stream beta, is tarike se kar, live stream tutorial. Okay. So how to live stream on YouTube. Complete beginner guide. So what we as humans have now started doing is we are trying to use software as a service. So there are a lot of explainer videos, tutorials, which are there. Videos can also be used for, you can say, building trust. Like, let's say, aapne dekha hoga, let's see these examples. These might be testimonials. So now if you're a company who has grown big, you might use video to build trust. So what? How do you build trust? You have to show your users in the right light. So here they are showing Pooja Burman, mother of Kush and Athar. And she's now talking about, you can say, how these kids actually got benefited through Byju's. They have some bites of Athar. They have some bites of the other guy and the mom in a certain way, and they take these videos in a certain way, edit it so that it builds trust. Now, these will be obviously used in their marketing cycle. They are coming from, this guy is from Moradabad. So imagine Moradabad mein Byju's use ho raha hai. So all the people who are around that area or in that area, they will be shown this video on social media. So ट्रस्ट बिल्ड करने के लिए भी आप वीडियो यूज कर सकते हैं. ओके, सो टेस्टिमोनियल आपको लेना पड़ेगा. एंड टेस्टिमोनियल्स आर समथिंग व्हिच पीपल वांट टुडे एनी डे, लाइक टुडे मोर देन एनी डे, राइट? बिकॉज़ देयर इज सो मच ऑफ कंपटीशन. देयर इज वेबिनार. राइट नाउ वी आर एक्चुअली यूजिंग वीडियो. दिस पर्टिकुलर, लाइक द कॉल व्हिच यू गाइस आर ऑन, दिस इज अ वेबिनार. वेबिनार इज नथिंग एल्स बट अ वीडियो फॉर्मेट. What we do is we record these videos. Okay, currently this session is being recorded. And if you go onto our website, singularity.in/webinars, you will figure out all the webinars. Like last week, a webinar for those people who have missed it, it's actually there. So if you go online and check this out, you will get this particular webinar out there. Okay, next week, ye webinar bhi aa jayega. So we are using. What we are doing is we are recording the video, we are putting up this video. So this is where, you know, video kis cheez ke liye chahiye, ye bahut important hai. And that is what is your brief going to be about. Then the pre-production. Pre-production is again simple in terms of video. It is more about who are going to be the key players. Okay, like say for example, right now a webinar, let's think of it, let's simplify this further. For this particular webinar to happen, what I need to do a pre-production is I need to build a PPT. Okay, we need to do some amount of social media pe ads and everything, but that is not pre-production still. But mujhe ye video specifically banane ke liye, I need, let's say, ek Zoom ka invite mujhe bhejna hai jo aap tak pahunche. I need to actually have a PPT. Okay, so who are going to be the key players? Attendees. Who is the person? So Jeet is going to take it on his laptop. Okay, using Zoom. I am answering all these things in my pre-production. Jeet ke paas ek PPT ya slideshow hona chahiye. So Jeet should have an agenda again. Now, this is my pre-production. My production is actually for a webinar. This is currently my production. So what I need to just do is, you need, now let's simplify Jeet. You need an expert, okay, who knows the subject. And then production mein, I can just hit record and the expert is actually demonstrating. Okay, the expert is demoing. We capture the video. And Q&A, agar ho sakta hai, toh Q&A hona chahiye. That is it. So what you need is for doing a webinar, and think of it, any webinar is actually a webinar done by an expert. Okay, if you have attended other webinars also, the person has an agenda set. So you need a topic and the person actually executes it. Okay, so webinar production is fairly simpler. Post-production mein kya hoga? Post-production mein webinar ke liye, let me just type this down. So post-production mein, right now, you know, all these moments where I am actually kind of doing this live and I'm thinking about stuff, or I am wasting time, or I am fumbling maybe. Okay, there might be times when, because I'm doing it in a live environment from my home, there might be a doorbell which rings and I have to open the door, let's say when I'm talking to you guys. Now that is not something which people would appreciate in a not so live situation. Live situation mein you guys can understand. But otherwise, people will not, like if someone comes to my website and they go through the webinar and usme bhi wo issue hai, wo mistake hai, then there's an issue. So edit out, post-production mein we edit out all the errors, you know, the fumbles. That's one clear thing. Audio refine karna hai, master karna hai. Mastering is nothing else but audio ke andar there are, you know, background noise jitna kam kar sakte hain and audio ko jitna thoda refine kar sakte hain in terms of clarity. So that is what mastering is all about. So this is right now what I am talking about over here. This is video creation but webinar ka. Okay. So audio define kar diya, master kar diya. Uske baad performance ka review. Okay, what will be the performance review? The performance review for this particular thing will be ki how many people registered versus attended. You know, how many people dropped off? Maybe I am, you know, this topic is not appealing to you guys. How many people actually left midway? So imagine if there are a lot of people who are dropping off midway, like koi 10 minute baad someone dropped off, someone dropped off in 20 minutes, someone dropped off, but most of the people, let's say we say 20 minutes mein drop off ho gaye. And the webinar is supposed to be maybe a 2-hour webinar. That's a very bad performance. Now, this is where we need to understand ki maybe there might be the expert might not be such a like comfortable with that particular topic. So, wo topic mat chhedo. So pick up some other topic. The audience might be wrong. Okay. The people who had, there might be some technical issue. I don't know. So ये सारी चीजें अपने को समझना पड़ेगा कि and this is what performance review is going to be all about. Now, when we get this, we will understand over a period of time. Like right now, we have done these many webinars. So I have got actual data ki which particular topic worked the best with people. Okay. Now, when I have that one particular core ki what topic worked with people, second thing is what are the questions people are asking. So I am getting a lot of insights into this. Ki what is the main issue which people are facing? Like right now, one of my number one insights through the webinar actually has been, when I say this all, I see content to be the number one blocker for people. Content, people are struggling with content is what my analysis has been. And why they are struggling with content? Because content har jagah pe chahiye, alag alag tariqo se chahiye. तो वो समझना इसलिए थोड़ा मुश्किल हो जाता है. सो दिस इज वेयर यू नो आई हैव मेड माय फर्स्ट वर्कफ्लो वाज जेनरिक, लाइक वेबसाइट कैसे अपडेट करते हैं, इवेंट मार्केट कैसे करते हैं, ईमेल कैसे मार्केट करते हैं, एंड नाउ दिस इज कम्प्लीटली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ब्लॉग राइटिंग एंड वीडियो क्रिएशन. सो कॉन्टेंट के बारे में हम लोग बात करें बिकॉज आई नो दिस इज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड पीपल नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज अ फाउंडेशनल टॉपिक एक्चुअली. ओके. The second part to this is, let's, so that was video creation webinar. I didn't plan to cover that, but I did because it was natural. Video creation. Now this video creation is going to be different. This is going to be a more, you can say, let's imagine aapko ek video shoot karna hai, which is a live video, and you want to shoot this live video for your brand. So what goes into that? Is what I want to with, which is what I am interested in to actually cover. So who is your target audience? Brief mein chahiye. What is your product, service, USP, benefits, competitor analysis yahan pe bhi hona chahiye. If you are in a field, if you are doing business, there cannot be a chance ki aapke paas competitor nahi hai. To aapka competitor kya kar raha hai ye aapko pata hona chahiye, and you should do one of better than them or maybe 10x better than them. So that's how you build your brief. Then you give this brief to someone who can actually work on this, you know. So maybe a script writer. Okay. So script writer aapke paas hona chahiye. Now, this is where things get little confusing. Not all video creators are script writers. Not all script writers are video creators. So you need someone who has experience of this. You can't go to your blog guy and tell them ek script likh de. Now this is something which I understood over a period of time. Basically, there was this one project which we got, and in this particular project, we had to create a video ka script. So what I normally did is I picked up that video. And I picked up the project and I gave it to a person who claimed that they could write script. They were actually writing scripts for TV shows. So I said, "Likh sakte hain. Chahiye to she can write it." And I actually outsourced it to her, but she was struggling because she has never worked on a marketing product. So she does not know the angle to take ki market kaise karna hai logo ko through video. So this is where she was more into, you know, writing about drama or tragedy. So this is where I understood ki it's a very big gap and people are not understanding this. Now, mere paas issue kya ho gaya tha? Ki I have already given this, I have already taken this project. I did not cost in or factor in the cost of the script writer. And then when I went to actual professionals, they were charging me a bomb. And it was like ki I need all my budget for my production day. Mera ek din ka shoot tha, jo production ka hone wala tha. But wo ek din ka shoot was somewhere around, if I were to tell you, 80,000 to 1 lakh rupees ka kharcha.
So this is where I understood ki I do not have a budget of a script writer. So what should I do? Now this is where Indian dima, Jugaad dima, I'm like, let me write the script. So I actually worked on it and I did knock it off. And maybe it took me some time to start off, but within 6 hours or something, I actually created the script. Script kiya, script ke baad storyboard kiya. Okay, shared the storyboard with the client because client ko script nahi samajhne wala. Storyboard share kiya, client approved it immediately. We started working with the actor. So you have to select and work with the actor. In case if you have a script, like normally now a lot of videos which are happening, and this is even true for you if you are wanting to create your own videos of, you know, yourself talking in front of the camera. And the moment when you do that, when you start talking in front of the camera and you're thinking, I will put this up on YouTube or Instagram or whatever, you will figure out it is difficult. So this is where you will figure out ki shayad se aapko ek thoda kacha pakka script to chahiye. Now ye kacha pakka script aapko chahiye rahega, and aapko khud ke sath agar karna hai, experiment karo ek bar. Just write some few lines on a particular topic and just switch on the camera, and you will see you are not able to get the right emotion. To get comfortable and get the right emotion is where the you can say mastery comes in. So this is where we selected an actor. So again, actor select karna bhi ek alag process hai. You have to audition people and all those things. So all of that happened over here, right? When I'm saying selected, it's not just that. We had to do an audition. Now audition, itna kuch complicated bhi nahi hai. Today, because of Facebook, how we got the actor, I will tell you that. What we did is, on Facebook, there are a couple of groups where you can put up your requirement, where we put up our requirement and we started getting in Facebook messages. Out of those Facebook messages, we saw few profiles and we shortlisted few actors. When we shortlisted these actors, we started asking them, you know, their budget and their availability. Wahan pe hi bahut sare log filter out ho gaye. The person who we selected, like there were two people who we really liked, and we gave them the script to audition. And we asked them, mujhe sirf ye chhota sa emotion, how will you do it? Just share. So when they shared that, it was clear there were only two people who stood out for us. And one was not available, the other one was. So we said, say yeah. We started then, we called them up to our, you can say, workspace. We started working with them, working with her for maybe 2-3 days over calls and over Zoom calls, or over, you can say, even in real life. We did some test shots and then we were good to go. We said, shoot ke day pe milte hain, ye costume rahega, costume ka fitting, ye sab dekh liya. And we met on the shoot day. Shoot day ke liye, you need to have a lot of prep. You need to, you know, abhi pre-production mein other things are rentals. Rentals will be for lights, cameras. You will need, you can say, spot boys. Okay, so you will need a crew basically, and you will need to transport maybe some stuff. So ye sari cheeze aapko dekhni hogi. Okay, if you have a, we were doing a chroma shoot, so our requirement was a chroma background. And we didn't have a lot of set or anything. Kyunki chroma pe tha. Chroma is nothing else but green screen, for just to simplify. So this is where, you know, it became very simple for us to transport a lot of stuff. And it was, this is pre-COVID times I'm talking about. So tabhi itne restrictions bhi nahi the. Production ke din, everyone, there will be a time to start. Okay. And stop. ये पहले ही किसी को दे दो, ये time है भाई, this is your time to start and stop. You need to have you can say someone to be in check of the entire crew. So you need to have all your short breakdowns. एक short breakdown का sheet होता है, वो होना चाहिए, wherein all the shots are done. You need one person to check on continuity. कि if there is a cut, till what line has the person spoken and where were they standing when they spoke it, and so that they can continue with the same emotion. So there needs to be someone who actually focuses on that. If not, like, it's not a compulsory thing, but it's great to have it. This is what good videos have. You need someone to actually work with the actor. So actor ke saath continuously you need someone to be there. You need one person who will play the role of a babysitter. The babysitter ka role bahut simple hai. They need to look at the comfort of the entire crew and everyone. Because the environment on the production day is going to be very hectic. Everyone is, you know, in urgency and everyone wants to do their work to the best capability. Emotions are running high. So, ek banda ya bandi, uska kaam ye rehna chahiye ki koi bhi panga ho raha hai, कोई भी किसी भी चीज का, जैसे खाना टाइम पे ब्रेक करना, खाना सबके लिए प्रॉपरली अरेंज करना, ओके, ऑल दोज थिंग्स रियली मैटर. दोज आर स्मॉल थिंग्स बट दोज रियली मैटर. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम कॉलिंग देम अ बेबी सिटर. नाउ द प्रोडक्शन स्टार्ट्स. वंस द प्रोडक्शन स्टार्ट्स, इट्स ऑल यू नो लाइट्स कैमरा एक्शन. So that will be the main thing which will keep on happening. Repeat hoga, ye hoga, wo hoga. Finally, you need someone to take backups. This is the most important person. Backups, kabhi backups hona chahiye. Just so that, like, just the other day we did a shoot and you know, I thought I copied all the data onto my hard disk. And after a month, when I checked it, and this happened to me just day before, after a month, actually, I checked it and some of the data is missing. And my entire evening was really bad because I was just going on cursing myself. How did this even happen? I didn't understand. So that's why I'm saying you need to have a lot of backup so that you don't, you know, screw it up. Again, you are paying for all of this. Itna sab jo चल रहा है, आप उसके लिए पे कर रहे हो. सो यू नीड टू गेट दिस राइट एंड यू नीड टू गेट दिस राइट फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम. ओके, सो यू नीड टू कीप ऑल दिस बैकअप एंड एवरीथिंग रेडी. नाउ फाइनली व्हाट यू नीड इज द राइट पर्सन टू डायरेक्ट इट. ओके, सो डायरेक्टर ऑब्वियसली एंड अ ग्रेट कैमरामैन. सो दीज गाइज आर द पीपल हु विल मेक और ब्रेक योर शूट. सो डायरेक्टर और कैमरामैन दोनों एक्सपीरियंस्ड होंगे तो आपका अच्छे से काम हो जाएगा. सो दिस इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन एंड इट विल बी अ हेक्टिक डे. इट विल बी, आराम से आप सोच सकते हो, 8 घंटे का कॉल टाइम या 8 घंटे का वो शिफ्ट होता है, बट जो 12 घंटे तक आराम से जाता है एंड उसके पहले और बाद में भी काम रहता है. सो इट्स अ 16 to 18 hour डे, a production day. Okay, so that's what you need to keep on checking. Post production, you have to whatever data has been. So first is a scratch edit. So what happens is, and this can happen right on the set, you can have an editor who has all the data and they can just, you know, put in everything together. So jo bhi shot hote ja raha hai, unke paas script hai, unke paas video bhi aate ja raha hai. They will keep on, you know, working on this. This guy's editors are normally very chill people. So this guy will just keep on, aap jaise jaise data dete jaoge, he will start analyzing it and he will start lining it up. So ek scratch edit ban sakta hai aapka fatafat. Scratch edit mein aapko scratch sound bhi aap dal sakte ho. Okay. Here, one more person you will need maybe is the sound guy. So this is, yeah, this is a very important person. Like, maine yahan pe nahi dala. Sound is another important thing which is out there. So scratch sound and scratch music. Okay. Then aap director ko, director and editor ka jugalbandi ke baad ek cut niklega, which will be the main cut. Okay. That main cut is something what we are working towards. Ye main cut hoga, main cut aapke paas aaya with the sound, with the music, everything. I'm simplifying things here. you've got the sound, you have edited, mastered it, you have lined it up with the video, you have also put in music, background score, thoda bahut, and this all happens and you get your final video. Okay, so there is some amount of sound engineering which is required, okay, and mastering. And finally, export it to various formats. Aajkal jo formats chal rahe hain, like for YouTube, you have your HD formats or 4K formats. If you want a 4K output, you need to shoot in 4K first. So HD is still a go-to. You might need a square format for Instagram or something. Instagram ya dusre social media pe square format sab jagah pe chalta hai, to aapko ek HD mein chahiye rahega, ek square chahiye rahega. Aapko iska agar ek bada video hai to uska behind the scene ya kuch banana hai to ye bhi ek cheez aap kar sakte ho, but that's a additional thing. You might need a 9x16 video, which is a story format video, vertical video basically. So these are few formats which you will need things in. Performance review, again, when you have uploaded it, how many views are you getting? How many people watched it? Okay, where are people dropping off? This is data which you can get from Facebook. Even I think YouTube will give you this analytic wherein which point are people dropping off on. You know, so there is a saying in YouTube or normally videos jab internet ke liye bana rahe ki aapka first 5 seconds really matter. So these first 5 seconds need to be really, really, you can say energetic, which keeps the audience in the loop. So this is where it actually is going to help you if you understand ki where exactly people are dropping off. And at that point, it might be a need ki jahan pe aapko कुछ चेंज करना पड़ेगा. ऑब्वियसली यू कैन डू द चेंज ऑन दिस वीडियो, ये तो अपलोड हो चुका है, बट दूसरे वीडियो में इट्स इनसाइट फॉर अनदर वीडियो, राइट? सो यू विल गेट टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज वर्किंग, व्हाट इज नॉट वर्किंग ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. आई एम टेलिंग यू, वीडियो इज वन फॉर्मेट विच इज ग्रोइंग लाइक क्रेजी एंड इट इज गोइंग टू ग्रो फर्दर. सो इट विल बी रियली हेल्पफुल इफ यू गाइज गेट योर हैंड्स ऑन टू दिस. सो even this workflow is useful for people who are not doing professional shoots, but you guys want to shoot an ad for your own product. Okay, because for no matter who you are, you will need video to market your product or service. So this is where it will help you. I hope this is insightful in terms of, you know, what goes behind a video creation workflow. Okay, I will have to make one more copy of this, is what I understand. Part two ka part two. Okay. So any questions till now? Please let me know in the chat. Anything on top of your mind, I would love to hear from you guys, because I am talking about this because I really know the value of these things. So that's why I want others to understand. But if you guys have any doubts which are popping up, please feel free to ask. The next thing, so this is the content creation part of it. Ek aur ek jo cheez hai, ad ke liye bhi, actually, it's more or less the same thing, but I will cover one part for an ad. Okay, which is one second. When you're making now, ad can be, you know, ads can also be static, like image based ads. Now the whole idea about ads and which people get wrong, okay, you obviously need to have you can say you want to highlight your product and service. Okay, you want to understand what your competitors are doing, and you know, all these things really do matter. You need to first have a bunch of ads ka topics. Now, what are bunch of ads ka topics? Sudhakar, yes, I will be sharing these documents or links with you guys. I'll be sharing it on your email ID itself. Maybe I'll keep it on a public drive so that everyone can access this. It will only have read to access. So at the end of this session, so Tanmay, if you can share all the people who have attended the first and second session, I will be sharing these links with them. So, yeah. So first thing which we require is a bunch of ads ka topics. What I mean by this is, understand one thing. You're running a business. If I ask you, what is the date when you will stop running your business? Most of the people are going to say, I am running the business forever. Okay. Similarly, ads or marketing is something which is known as the infinite game. You are continuously doing this. Okay. You will be continuing not just now, but forever is what the intention is. Now, when you have that intention, you need to have a bunch of ads ka topics with you so that you can experiment tons of things. Okay. So that you can actually come up with a bunch of things. Now, what I mean by this is, when you come up with a problem of, let's say, mujhe ads banane hai and mujhe ek ad banana hai mere liye, to aapke paas kuch data nahi rehne wala hai when you work on that. Okay. Similarly, when you are working on, you are wanting to some artists to work on these ads, and if you give them just one ad to create, they are not going to be creatively satisfied and you are not going to, you know, get the right kind of output. So jaise blogs ke liye maine kaha ki ek bunch of blogs aap de do wo bande ko ya bandi ko, blog writer ko. Similarly, ads jab aap de rahe ho to ads bhi bahut sare do unko. Okay, so this is something which is required. Now just a second. So this is something which is required and which is, you know, to be experimented with. Now, why I'm saying this is, most of the people where they go wrong with ads is they just create few ads right now. So to give you an example, if I'm running an e-commerce business, then what I want to do in the e-commerce business is I want to run ads for everything. Okay. I want to run ads for all my products. So that means jitne mere products hai, utne mere ads honge. At the same time, I want to talk about my service also, because even if it's a product based business, but I have to deliver it, I have to ship it. People are thinking, are you a trustworthy company? So on and so forth. So आपके पास ये सारी टॉपिक्स हैं जिसके ऊपर एड्स बन सकती है. सो दिस इज वेयर व्हेन यू गिव दिस काइंड ऑफ अ फ्रीडम टू समवन टू वर्क विद योर ब्रांड, दे विल क्रिएट अ लॉट मोर, यू कैन से, वैल्यू फॉर यू इन टर्म्स ऑफ एड्स. नाउ द प्री प्रोडक्शन पार्ट, व्हाट दे नीड टू डू ऑब्वियसली इज कॉम्पिटिटर एनालिसिस, कॉन्टेंट गैप, ऑल दोस थिंग्स, कि कॉम्पिटिटर क्या कर रहा है. One thing which is required is a mood board. A mood board is required, and this is mainly for, you know, what are the different kind of ads which are running by competitors. एक competitor mood board बन सकता है, और एक mood board बन सकता है जो आप बना रहे हो as aspiration. Okay, so let me just write this: competitor mood board versus aspiration mood board. So what this will help is, when you give this information to the designer, or when you ask them, I am looking for this from you, they will actually put in their time to lay down the ads, and jitna wo log research karenge utna unka dimag chalne wala and utna insight wo aapko dene wale. Okay, so finally, pre-production say there should be insights and there should be a lot of you can say material to build ads. Now production ke point of view say, you first need a copywriter, okay, to work on the copy. So copywriter will work on the copy and they will actually write all the ads. Then their point of view. They need to explain their point of view, needs to be explained to the graphic designer. Okay, they need to actually walk the graphic designer through their mindset and why they are saying what they are saying. Even then, the graphic designer will be able to give you a lot more data rather than just saying ki, okay, aapne mujhe copy de diya, main bana dunga. Because the graphic designer does not know this. The graphic designer will also, he will be going through the mood boards and everything, but still, when conversation happens is when magic will happen. Then, based on this information, the graphic designer starts making first drafts. Okay? First draft, wo aapko dikhayega, and ask the graphic designer to pitch it to you. Do not ask them to just show it for the heck of it. You know, do not tell them ki, ab mujhe email kar do and I will check it out. Ask the graphic designer for a Zoom call. Ask them to present it to you. What they will appreciate is, they will appreciate the time which you are taking to understand from them their insight, and they will do a better job. Trust me on this. Okay? So, ask for a pitch. Always, whenever you're working with any creative person, ask them to pitch it to you. Ask them to pitch their work. And this is how work happens in agency. Agency mein, normally, designer, like factory-based agencies are also there, but there are also agencies which, wherein they plan and they give the designer that freedom to pitch their own ideas and thoughts. And this pitch is going to help you create this. Ask them, and when you tell someone to pitch, what they do is, you are asking them to show their best foot forward. Whereas, when you ask someone to, you know, create something for you, ye bana ke mujhe exactly ye chahiye, they are going to work like a factory worker. Okay, they will just push some buttons, they will create some graphic, and they will show it to you. That's it. You are not going to get the additional insights which you would have got otherwise. So that's why I asked for a pitch. Then you need to post. Post means basically publish it. So go live with the ads. Again, when you are going live with the ads, you need the audience targeting. Okay, so you need someone who is in the social media ad space or Google ad space to actually work with you. Jo audience ko properly target karega. If possible, the person should do audience targeting against A, B, and C, three or four kinds of audiences. Then they need to come up, like once they are running the ads, they need to share insights with you. Okay, so insights, when they will share, ki, okay, this audience is performing better than this audience, X, Y, and Z. So this is where you will get to understand even audience performance. So, okay, let's say they will give their insight. In performance review, what you will be reviewing is the reach of the ad. Okay. You will be reviewing the content of the ad. Okay. Content performance, basically. So if you are now, you know, the initial idea, which I said, create a bunch of ads. If you are running multiple ads, you are easily going to get a lot of content data. Ye content chala, ye nahi chala. So if one of the angles which you thought about worked versus another, you got one step ahead, wherein you know now your audience is going to, you know, your audience likes this particular way of messaging versus this. Your audience likes this kind of a creative versus this. So this is the idea of content performance. You also need to have an audience audit done at this point, wherein you understand which is your proper audience. Is it male? Is it female? Is it youngsters? Is it higher earning individuals? Is it high spending individuals? Is it people who are in tier one, tier two cities? So much of data, right? So experiment with all of these things and get an idea. Jitna aap dekhoge, aapke paas aur wo data aate jayega. Okay, so this is how you can actually do this audience audit and everything. And finally, obviously the important metrics are reach hai, impressions hai, okay, reach and impressions. Reach is number of people where or accounts, unique accounts where your ad actually reached. Impressions are number of accounts where who saw the ad multiple times. Okay, so that is impressions. This data is very basic, but it just gives you a fair idea in initially ki kitne logo tak pahuncha. Okay, there are other metrics which are unique to each you can say each social media network. So brand lift is one wherein it shows you ki how much of your brand has been you know recognized by the audience and how much will they remember it. So this is something which obviously Facebook has some metrics around it, and that's how, or they have some science around it, and that's how they can tell you ki brand lift itna hua. So 2%, 8%, jo bhi rahega, it will tell you that data. So over a period of time, you will understand. Finally, there is ROAS, which is revenue on ad spend. Aapne ad chalaye, but usse revenue kitna generate hua. And this is the single most important metric which any person looks at when they are doing e-commerce. So this is the data which anyone needs when it comes to running ads. Okay. Now, if you saw one thing, what I have done. Okay. Let me just. Okay. So Manoj Shah, hi. Actually, happy morning. I saw your message. You want to see the previous slide? Sure. This is the previous slide. Any specific question around this? Okay, I hope that solves it. So what I have done in all of these things over a period of time is I have given you performance review. I've given you performance review. Now, this performance review, which I'm talking about all this time, right? That is actually nothing else but what do you analyze, okay? And analytics is the most important thing, okay? Analytics is the most important thing which determines ROI or which determines if you have invested in creating a blog or video or a post or whatever. What are you getting out of it? Okay. And where we need to analyze these things is it's again a simple formula, but which people have made it complicated. Analyze karne ka jo workflow hai, wo bahut simple hai, KPI. KPI is key performance indicator, jo aapke paas pehle hona chahiye. Jo stage one hai, strategize ka. Strategize ke time pe you should decide what are the KPIs going to be for this campaign. If you can decide that, if you can decide your KPIs during your strategy, your analysis stage starts from here. You just know what to track. You will tell your social media manager, or you will tell your SEO guy, or you will tell your Google Ads ka banda ya bandi, ki I need these KPIs to be met. So imagine, what are KPIs? Now KPIs can be awareness KPIs. I want to reach to 1 million accounts. I want to build awareness to at least 1 million people. Who are these 1 million people going to be? They are going to be, let's say I'm working for a software company and I'm trying to market a software product. So these people are going to be, let's say, architects and interior designers who use a particular piece of software in day in, day out, and I want to create awareness amongst them. This is a very specific audience. So if I have that during my strategy stage, I will be passing this information down throughout the campaign. And what will happen based on this is I will get lot of creatives done for this particular audience, and I will show target them through analytics target them through audience targeting and actually show them the ad. So my KPI will be met over a period of time versus KPI. आप बहुत लोग ऐसे करते हैं कि KPI देखते नहीं है, वो लोग ad चलाने के पीछे रहते हैं. So ad वो लोग चलाते हैं, उसके बाद वो लोग KPI ढूंढते हैं. So this is where I am saying in your strategy case, your KPI should be defined. Then what you just need to do is you need to go through a lot of data. What is this data going to be? Your either your Facebook console or maybe your any जो भी ad platform है उसका console. Similarly, you need to look at a lot of data, make those connections to get insights. So imagine if a lot of people are clicking on a particular creative and we are saying this creative works better versus others. That is an insight. Okay. So similar to that, you need to have a lot of data out. Like there is a lot of data out there, but you need someone intelligent to go through that to actually, you know, get the insights. Once you have the insights, what you need to do is put it in actionable steps so that it can be optimized for your next campaign. So this is a very simple workflow when it comes to analytics. And this is what needs to be followed. There is no other, like if anyone is telling you, I am doing analytics and they will give you a long list of things they are doing, they are not. They are confused. You give them this workflow, tell them, mujhe ye cheez batao in this order. Okay, these are my KPIs. Get me the data, fish out the insights and tell me how to optimize. If any analytics person or any ad person or any performance marketer is going to give you a report, okay, and this is what happens. People give you reports. They give you an ad report. They give you an SEO report. You are spending not for the report. Report card ke liye, we are not spending. What we are spending the money for is getting intelligence, which is insight and an optimization plan. So if your SEO guy comes up with the report at the end of the month, ask them, what is the insight? What is the optimization plan? Did we get the KPIs that we aimed for? That's it. Three questions. And if you don't get this, tell them, mujhe ye figure out karke do. Give them a chance to prove themselves and move ahead. Okay. So with that in mind, I think we are more or less through with the, you know, the workflows, which I wanted to talk about all this way. If you guys have any question with regards to marketing workflows, I know this was a more theory based topic, but I'm telling you, this is one of the most important things. If you are working with a bunch of people, if you are running your business or if you're planning to run your business, or if you're running an organization, working with maybe an agency, this single, like these two sessions actually make things a lot more simpler for people if they are doing any of these things. So with that said, there are a bunch of new sessions which we have lined up actually. Let me just go through that. So yeah, so Feb 6th, our next session is on Feb 6th, which is customer personas done right. So this is all about if you are running a business and if you want to, you know, market your business, or if you want to market your product, service, anything, and you want to ideally figure out who are you selling to. So that person or that particular personality becomes a customer persona around which all your campaigns or content will be placed. So how do you define this customer persona is what we will do with this in the next, you can say, session. After that, the following Saturday, we are doing campaign-based marketing strategy. So if you are thinking about marketing using campaigns, or if you are thinking about campaigns karna hai mujhe, and why campaigns are required is because if you are posting daily, okay, even if you are posting daily, what happens is over a period of time, people are getting the same old stuff. So campaigns are nothing else but those simple moment based things which are going to give you a lot more traction. And campaigns are done for various purpose. It's not just ki Valentine's Day aa raha hai to campaign kar lo, waisa nahi hai. The campaigns are mainly done for growth either of revenue or growth of audience or growing the account in some way or the other. So how campaigns are made, how we can actually do this. So we'll learn some strategies and tactics. So this is what is happening on Feb 13th. So there are a lot more things planned. I think we have a whole schedule coming of the next 10 sessions actually very soon in the coming week. So stay tuned for that. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask at this moment. What I will be doing at the end of this is all the people who have attended these sessions, I will be sharing these three sheets. That is workflow part one, part two, and part two ka part two. Okay. So these will be shared across as a read-only document so that you guys can access it and just check it out. And if it helps you, do let me know. And if there is any other thing which I can help you out with, get in touch. I think, yeah, more or less, that is it for today. This is me. This is where you can get in touch with me. Instagram, LinkedIn, email, right? So thanks a lot for attending this session. It was really great for me to share my experience and to share details on, you know, how you can actually make marketing workflows. One of my very favorite topics, because this is going to give you productivity. Okay. The moment you guys understand this, your teams, your way you work, your way you see things will change, is what my belief is. So till next time, guys, thanks a lot for your time. And it was really great having you guys. Cheers. Take care.